All right, so our next guest, senior film editor over at The Hollywood Reporter, please welcome Piya Sinha-Roy. You guys have been so busy monitoring your social feed. It's like as soon as news breaks, more breaking news follows it.
Yes, it is very much a barrage right now of news, and it's just coming at us, but everything is changing almost by the hour. So we have to keep up, and we're trying to make sure that we can like relay everything accurately.
Let's start with some of the films that were projected for release in the coming weeks.
Yeah.
Let's start with Fast and Furious.
So Fast and Furious was pushed back yesterday. That was meant to come out in May this year. It is now coming out in April next year. You have to wait a whole 11 months before you can see your next installment of Fast and Furious, F9.
Why push it back so far?
Well, the main thing was that I think they really want to make sure, you know, when movies are slated for release in the year, they have to always make sure every studio picks their slot and makes sure that they gives it the best slot they can for the best performance at the box office. So for a movie like F9, it's the summer box office. Everyone goes out to see it. They needed to make sure that it could give it its best shot at the box office. And right now, with a lot of postponements coming, we're now looking at the latter half of this year getting stacked up. So pushing it to next year now gives them that slot next year to give it its best shot, but people will have to wait.
Wow. Disney's Mulan is a real interesting one too, because this was in danger of not even showing in theaters in China.
Yes. So Mulan is coming out here. Well, it's meant to be coming out here in 2 weeks. It is no longer coming out, and it will be again pushed to later this year. And it was already, you know, just a month ago, once China closed around 70,000 theaters, that was already sort of not boding well for its release. But yeah, that pushback at the late stage that it was pushed back is not great for the studio.
I mean, can a film like that even find success without the China box office?
I think a film like that, yes, it can, because it's such a global film. Like Disney movies play internationally, but it's not going to help if a lot of those theaters, because it's not just China, it's so many nations affected now, and all of them are closing down, shutting down, or there's a social distancing. So because of those issues, I think, again, pushing it back is hopefully to give it its best shot so it can be seen by everyone. But, you know, there's still money lost here. All the money spent on marketing, the Super Bowl ads alone, you know, they spent millions on those. That is, you know, all of that is lost right now.
Now, do they have to allocate additional marketing funds for the new release?
I mean, they'll have to. You know, you can't release a movie without getting it out there. I know for A Quiet Place 2, that was scheduled to be released in theaters next week, that movie has pretty much spent most of its marketing budget because it's about to come out. So yes, I think they are going to have to reassess and spend some money again before those movies come out.
What about the exhibitors? Are they giving you a sense of how far off business is so far?
I think this week and this weekend will be very telling. Last weekend was sort of muted box office, but Disney's family-friendly film Onward was released and opened to about 40 million. It's a pretty low number for a Pixar Disney movie, but hopefully, you know, we'll get a better idea of this weekend, because I think theater-going behaviors are going to change extensively, and I think from then onwards we can assess how it's going to shape up.
Yeah.
Wow. All right. Piya Sinha-Roy, thank you so much for your insight. You could follow Piya on Twitter as Piya S. Roy, and follow The Hollywood Reporter at, what is it?
The Hollywood Reporter. Oh, at THR.
At THR? Okay. There you go. We'll be right back.